So this is a one example, very good example for the limiting reactant problem. Limiting reactant. Question. When hydrogen sulfide H2S gas is bubbled into the solution of sodium hydroxide, the reaction forms sodium sulfide and water. What is the maximum amount of sodium sulfide in gram that can be formed if 1.5 gram of hydrogen sulfide is bubbled into the solution containing 1.65 gram of sodium hydroxide? So to solve this question, first you have to find out the molecular formula for each naming of chemical is given here. Like hydrogen, when hydrogen sulfide gas, H2S gas is already given, is bubbled into a solution of sodium hydroxide. So we know the sodium hydroxide is NaOH. And sodium hydroxide, the reaction forms sodium sulfide and water. So sodium sulfide, you have to find out the calculation, molecular formula. And or the ionic formula, basically. This is ionic compound. And then water molecule. So what is the maximum amount of sodium sulfide? So they are asking maximum amount of sodium sulfide means they are asking about the theoretical yield in the gram that can be formed if 1.5 gram of hydrogen sulfide is bubbled into solution. If 1.5 gram of sodium sulfide, hydrogen sulfide gas is bubbled into 1.65 gram of sodium hydroxide. So this is a very good example of limiting reactant, and to solve this question there are two methods. Either you can convert every gram quantities into moles and then compare mole, find out the limiting reactant, because you can see from this reaction one mole of H2S gas is reacting with the 2 moles of sodium hydroxide. So if you have less sodium hydroxide, so limiting reactant will be sodium hydroxide. If you have less H2S gas, then H2S gas will be limiting reactant. But to find out the which one is the limiting reactant, so either you can use method A or method B. So method A, convert all the gram quantities into mole and compare the moles, find out the limiting reactant, and use that limiting reactant to calculate the other product. And then convert mole to gram for final answer. Another way to convert mole to molar mass, and then molar mass into the grams, and then compare molar mass and gram, find out the limiting reactant. So if you do not want to convert the gram quantities into mole, what you can do, you can find out the molecular mass of each reactant, and then you can compare in the gram quantities and then calculate product in the gram quantities using the limiting reactant. But here I will show you the how to solve this question using method A, which is very easy compared to the method B. So let's understand this question. So first, whenever you have to solve any question, you have to write the chemical equation first and make sure that this reaction is a balance. So 2 hydrogen and 1 hydrogen is this side, 3 hydrogen and the hydrogen are only 2 hydrogen on this product side. So hydrogen are not balanced. And sulfur, one sulfur on the reactant side, another sulfur is on the product side. So some sulfur is balanced. One sodium atom on the reactant side, 2 sodium on the product side, so this is not balanced. So this is not a chemically balanced reaction, so we have to balance this reaction first. So first step is to balance the chemical equation, which is a H2S gas 1, and then you have to add 2 because we need 2 sodium on the reactant side. So 2 NaOH, and then we have 2, and after that the 2 oxygen and 2 and 2, 4 hydrogen will be there. So we have to add 2 more in front of, 2 coefficient more in front of water. So now this equation will be balanced. So what we have to do, So now we can say that 1 mole of S2S gas, because here is not coefficient is not there, so it means this is a 1 mole, is reacting with the 2 mole of NaOH to produce 1 mole of sodium sulfide and 2 mole of water. And now they are giving that according to this question, you can see that they are saying 1.5 gram of hydrogen sulfide. So 1.5 gram of hydrogen sulfide is bubbling into solution of containing 1.6 gram of sodium hydroxide, 1.65 gram of sodium hydroxide. So since we know the gram quantities, so I will convert these gram quantities into moles first. So mole is equal to, how to convert the mole? Mole is equal to gram quantities divided by molar mass. So 1.50 gram divided by molar mass is 2 plus, and molar mass of hydrogen atom is 1 plus sulfur is 32. Once you will calculate this one, the answer will come 0.044 mole of S2S gas. And then the molar mass, and then we have to find out the moles of sodium hydroxide. So 1.65 gram divided by 23 plus 16 plus 1. So 23 is for sodium, 16 is for hydrogen, oxygen, and then 1 for hydrogen. So 1.65 divided by gram divided by 40 gram per mole. So gram will be cancelled out. Answer will come in the mole. So now we know that we have 1.5 gram, which is equal to 0.044 mole of S2S, is going to be bubbled into 1.65 gram of sodium hydroxide solution, which is equal to 0.041 mole of NaOH available. Now we have to find out with these two mole, which one is our limiting reactant. So find out if we find out how much sodium hydroxide is required if we use 0.44 mole of S2S. If we want to use, if we want to consume all the S2S gas, how much NaOH is required? So you can see the ratio between the NaOH and S2S gas is 2 mole is required for 1 mole of S2S. So how many moles of NaOH will be required if we are using 0.044? Basically it will be just double of this one, right? So x mole of NaOH will be 2 mole NaOH, and then 1 mole of S2S, and then 0.044 mole of S2S will be cancelled out, and 2, it will be just double mole. But you can see this much is required and we have only 0.041, so this is less. So let's find out the, so basically look like this is not my S2S is not my limiting reactant. So find out, now we have to find out if we will consume, how much S2S is required if we use 0.041 mole of NaOH. If we completely consume this much of NaOH, how much S2S gas will be required. So again, so the ratio of NaOH is 2 by 1, and then here it will be changed for, we know the NaOH, now we have to find out S2S. So this would be kind of almost half of this one. So whatever the amount of NaOH you have, if you want to consume total NaOH, then you need half of this S2S gas. So now you can compare, this is required and this is required, right? So now compare the required and available to find out the limiting reactant. So you can see this is the available amount, 0.041, this is 0.044, and required is 0.0488, which is not, we do not have that much NaOH, right? But we have enough amount of S2S gas. So S2S gas is excess, because we need only 0.0205, but we have 0.44 mole of S2S gas. So this is in excess, and NaOH is limiting reactant. So we will use the NaOH use the limiting reactant to calculate the product quantity. So we'll use the NMH quantity to find out the sodium hydroxide, sodium sulfide gas calculation. So what to do next? Let's move these papers from here. So now we know that NaOH is our limiting reactant. So next step will be use the ratio of the reactant and product to find out the mole quantities. So now you can see 2 moles of NaOH will give 1 mole of H2S gas, right? And we have seen that we have available is 0.041 mole of NaOH is available. So if 2 mole is giving 1 mole of H2S, how many moles of H2S sodium sulfide will be obtained? If we will use 0.41 mole NaOH, it would be just half of this one. How we will find out? We will use this ratio, 2 mole of NaOH divided by 1 mole of H2S gas will be equal to these many mole of sodium hydroxide and then x mole of sodium sulfide. So this would be half millimole. Or you can also compare with this one, that this to completely consume sodium hydroxide 0.41, we will require only 0.205 mole of sodium H2S gas, and since 1 mole of H2S gas is producing 1 mole of sodium sulfide, so same mole of required amount of H2S gas will produce the same mole of sodium sulfide, which is equal to 0.025 mole. Now what we have to convert? We have to convert this number of moles into gram. So number of moles will be equal to gram mass in the gram quantities divided by molar mass. So gram quantity will be equal to number of moles multiplied by molar mass, which is molar mass of sodium sulfide. So number of moles multiplied by 2 multiplied by 23 plus 32. So sodium have 23 and sulfur has 32. So once you will multiply, so this will be the final answer, that 1.60 gram of sodium sulfide will be formed in this question. What is the maximum amount of sodium sulfide? So this would be the maximum amount of 1.60 gram of sodium sulfide will be the maximum amount of sodium sulfide will be formed in this question. And this would be the theoretical yield. This will be theoretical yield. And if you are getting less than this one, then that will be actual yield. This is theoretical yield. So, and then you can find out the percentage based on the actual yield and theoretical yield comparison.